I'm the last person that would ever want to get involved in politics. I stay well away from it, and besides not being interested in it, you know, I see it as just sort of a big fight, and business and money really dictates and creates sort of rules and regulates everything. However, I've got this old, you know, notepad, and at one stage I was hearing all sorts of very, very strange things on the radio in Australia, and I've recorded just a handful of them here as I heard them come across on the radio on the news. This is a period, I've got a note here from the 9th of the 4th, 2014, and I was just hearing the most strange reports and news on the radio, and I started making a note of it, and I'll just read out my notes and then I'll talk about them. I see this time as a political party has been elected. And what I'm going to call this speech is recreating the 70s. I see the people in power at the moment as a people that grew up in the 70s and want to recreate the 70s. However, the way I'm thinking is that the 1970s was awesome, it was great, but today we live in a different age. We live with different people with different DNA. We live with far more people living on the earth than before, and there's less space between people, and you need more rules and regulations to make it all work. So the 70s was great, but the 1970s belong in the 1970s, and it's a time that can't be recreated. So I'll read out my notes. Open abuse of bikies allowed was one of the news reports. Open expression, racism and abuse. On the 9th of the 4th, 14, I recorded that every Australian state minister, and apparently this happened, they went to Japan, Korea and China, etc., to remove tariffs and restrictions. On the 9th of the 4th, 14, a move to make children's playgrounds more dangerous. And just so far as the technology industry and better technology concerning transport and motors and just everything, that a core drill had really gone through the government had come into the organisation, thrown people out, and I heard the comment that a core drill had been taken to the technology sector or development sector. Yeah, so I've noticed that things have settled down, and I haven't really heard as many stories that make you go, what? So much recently. So it's the fourth that I was noticing this going on, and it's now the 8th of the 2014. Open abuse of bikies. Yeah, I remember hearing on the radio everywhere that you are allowed to see a bikie, and you would be able to just call this person anything you wanted. You know, I'm not going to say the words that that you'd be able to say, because you know, it's not my scene to use this kind of language. You know, that you would be able to actually single out a bikie and call him any name you wanted and act towards him any way you wanted. You know, a bikie. Okay, so this is the tricky bit. I don't believe that you should sell drugs or hurt people or behave aggressively. But So long as a person isn't doing that, and he just likes motorbikes and he likes riding around, and he owns a Harley Davidson, it might be loud or whatever. These are types of people that you're talking about, and like any type of person, if you single out a type of person, so long as he's not breaking the law, you're going to get a backlash. So in response to the open abuse of bikies, that's really not good, and it's not good for society or the people themselves. It's completely un-Australian and shocking to hear on the radio that any political party would even consider allowing the open abuse of any type of person. Another thing I heard around about this time was the open expression allowed, racism and abuse allowed. That speaks for itself, and I know what I heard, and I won't go into that any further because, God knows what they were thinking when they were talking like that. 9th of the 4th, 14, every Australian state minister going to Japan and just removing all tariffs. That's economical. And, I think what a political party needs to realise is that all these rules and regulations have been put into place for a reason. They weren't just created and put into place for no reason at all. Something happened, and so it's like a law. Something happens, and so you bring in a law to make sure it doesn't happen again. There's a reason for it. Now, a move to make children's playgrounds more dangerous. So you can say that children are growing up, and they need to realise that life isn't as cushy and as safe as a child's playground, but these are people that they're only children, and they need to be protected while they're young. And later on, I assume they'll develop the skills to realise that the world is a very dangerous place. Coming in and getting rid of technology, that's really not a good sign. It's not a good move. We've got all these people, and their job is to, and their interest is to develop new technologies, and that's what they're good at. That's what's going to make the future work. And it's just not a good idea to come in and upset people. Don't do it. It's just not Australian. At the moment, we're experiencing prosperity. Things are going well. There's no real reason for big cutbacks. Let it be. Let it all work. And, if you're a government, just try to make people's lives better.